This is my channel, and today we are going to be talking about the glorification of thought culture. So welcome to the real talk. A lot of you guys are going to be very upset about what I got to say today, but it needs to be said. Of course, before we get started, make sure you guys comment down below. Have you ever dealt with a thought? Or are you a thought yourself? And what do you think about thought culture? Do you think that it is destroying this new generation, old generation? Do you think it's always been destroying all of the generations? Like, I'd love to hear your thoughts on thought culture down below as a whole. So with that being said, we gotta lay down a couple of things, okay? We are not talking about people who engage in sex work. I believe that is legitimate work, and people who choose to do that should be able to do so. And those people who engage in that said work know the consequences and don't need me or anyone else to tell them. I would hope that they know their consequences, so it is not for them. We are also not pushing the idea of modesty. We are pushing the idea of general common sense and people using their discretion and not just willy-nilly throwing shit in a circle just because they want to and then trying to call it sex positive. Go into slut shaming. And if you as a person are watching this and watch videos like this thinking that you're being slut shamed, that word is an oxymoron. And if you do not know what an oxymoron is, look it up. Because the fact that you're even regarding yourself as a slut is a fucking problem in itself, and you need to go figure yourself out, okay? No one is slut shaming anyone, and you should not refer to yourself as a slut at all. And that's a problem in a million ways in itself. Please go seek some motherfucking therapy. Culture. Essentially, we're talking about people who are genuinely and wholeheartedly promiscuous. People who throw it around in a circle. People who have sex with any and everything all the time, anytime, with whoever, whenever, with no regard, no protection, and no sense whatsoever. Do I really have to explain it? And no, this is not just women. Of course, I'm a woman, so I'm going to be speaking from woman's perspective. However, this goes for men too. You are just as equally disgusting for fucking anything that walks, just as well as any woman is disgusting for letting any man pipe her with no motherfucking regard or protection or the regard for self-worth. Point blank, period, okay? All y'all nasty. If you sitting here fucking any and everything, you're nasty. We all have our whole phases. Point blank, period. No one is holier than now. No one is better than anyone. However, we need to understand and be self-aware and be accountable for all of our actions. We all have had moments where we've probably had sex with people that we shouldn't have, or we've had sex with multiple people around a close range that we shouldn't have. However, it's about changing. It's about being self-accountable. It's about being self-responsible, and it's about making progress. If you're not making progress, here's a fucking problem. Essentially, a thought or a hoe is someone that has multiple partners, okay, multiple relations with multiple people in a short period of time. So today they messing with Harry, tomorrow they messing with Felicia, the next day they messing with Ashley, the next day they messing with Tim, the next day they messing with John, the next day they messing with Sean, the next day they messing with John, the next day they messing with, okay, you get the point. They messing with multiple people at the same given time. Now, I've seen a ridiculous amount of normalization with this.
Oh, well, you know, it's sex positivity.
Oh, you're slut shaming.
First of all, we already went through the whole problem with saying slut shaming. Y'all need to get it together. Shut the fuck up. This is not sex positivity. This is thought shit. Just call it thought shit. It's okay if you want to be a thought. Just call it thought shit. Say you's a hoe. Just say you like to fuck everything that walks. Just say that you like your shit stuck. That's it. Y'all need to stop this shit. Y'all need to stop normalizing this shit. And the same people that like to normalize this shit, the same people who like to talk about this shit, be the same people that will never tell the people the consequences of these actions. Sex positivity is being comfortable in your sexuality, not spreading your sexuality to the world in terms of spreading your genitals to the world, as in spreading your coot coot and your fluids and your souls to the world. world, not giving your energy, your cuckoo, your peen to the world. There's two different things. Two different things. It's not the same thing. When you sitting there on Twitter talking about how wet you are, telling people to send you pics, and Twitter's actually my favorite platform, but I just can't go down my timeline because the amount of pornography is just fucking disgusting and I just can't. Like, comment down below if you agree. Like, someone needs to stop this. Like, this is absolutely ridiculous. Like, I'm mad that the people I follow even like or retweet this stuff because that's clearly how I'm seeing it. But it's like, why do people even like this? Why y'all even posting this? It needs to be the same people complaining, talking about some, oh, well, I can't find a man, or men ain't shit, or bitches ain't shit, and bitches stuff that. Well, you're putting your sexcapades on the internet and no one wants somebody that has all their sexcapades on the internet. No one wants someone that has their nudes all over the internet willingly. Okay, if they get leaked, that's not your fault, but I'm saying willingly. No one wants to have someone that's for everybody. For everybody. Like, let's be real here. And I know there's gonna be people commenting down below, because when I did my whole live with Yanni, you guys definitely need to go check her out or check out the live down below. You were like, okay, name one girl that's promiscuous and posts photos online of herself of that nature that has a serious relationship. Better yet, that is married, that still posts those pictures. Y'all couldn't find not one, because there is none. You're not going to find a stable man in a stable relationship doing that type of shit. And it's the same thing for men. You are not going to attract a real woman that's about her shit, that's gonna stay with you and put up with you forever. She may put up with you for a minute, because women, we love to see the best in niggas. Let's be real, we do. But you're not gonna find someone that's stable and of substance, sitting there putting your sexcapades everywhere, putting your dick everywhere, putting your pussy everywhere. You're not, you're just not. Because no one wants to deal with that. That energy is horrible. The whole essence of it is horrible. Besides the fact that you're most likely not going to find a stable, wholesome partner. Of course you got STDs. I feel like nobody talks about STDs anymore. I feel like we just act like them shits don't exist. Of course we got culture, we got music, we got everything just promoting the fact that we can just willy-nilly fuck everybody and anything and that's gonna happen to us. But of course, STDs are a thing. It don't matter if you got birth control, that shit don't protect you. Y'all need to stop pushing that nonsense. I've seen that so many times. I'm like, where'd y'all get that from? Y'all ain't pay attention in health class? Clearly not. Do they have health class anymore? You can die from having certain STDs, especially since a lot of y'all don't like to go to the doctor anymore. Y'all wanna push these natural remedies. Okay, I wanna see how much these natural remedies stop you from getting gonorrhea, okay, getting chlamydia, getting HIV, getting AIDS, all of that. I would love to see it. I would really love to see it. This is very fucking serious, okay? Then of course, we have pregnancy. Do you really wanna be a single parent? And no, women are not the only people that end up being single parents. I know plenty of single fathers out there. I know a lot of you may not have seen them, but I know a good handful. That shit ain't sweet. Of course you can easily be married and be left. But again, that goes back to being wholesome, okay? And finding wholesome people and actually having discernment. You have to have discernment. Like, there's certain times where it's like, we all had that moment where it's like, oh my God, I love this person so much. This is a red flag, but like, I'm gonna ignore it because I love them and I know they can change and maybe it's just me. Honestly, use your gift of discernment. If you feel like something's wrong, if you see red flags, notice those red flags and understand the red flags are red flags for a reason. Do not ignore your gut. Do not ignore your gut. Your gut is there for a reason. Your discernment is there for a reason. Parfait, don't be stupid. I'm telling you right now, you're gonna be asked out. You do not wanna end up in a situation where you fucking and sucking everybody, you end up having a kid with somebody that's fucking garbage. And now your kid's inheriting that garbage. It's not even a fact of the matter of, oh, well, you don't wanna be pregnant and end up having a kid. It's the fact of when you have a kid with someone, your kid inherits that person's demons. Okay, your kid inherits that person's problems. Your kid inherits that person's trauma, their karma, and everything else. You do not just want to be willy-nilly laying down with everyone, giving anyone your seed, having anyone's baby. Because to be honest with you, that could be way worse of a situation than the thought culture in itself. I don't understand why people don't take this shit more seriously. Everyone out here is having a kid by 88 everybody, and I just don't understand it. Honestly, I have a whole video on the glorification of baby mother culture linked up above. Y'all need to watch that. Ooh, child, I went in on that one too. Of course, we have soul ties, right? I know a lot of people don't believe in this, but it's a legitimate thing, okay? Soul ties. Every single time you have sex with someone, you're essentially giving a part of yourself away. Unless, you know, you're really doing like rituals and stuff to like cleanse yourself, but like, let's be real, who really does that? Like, nobody got time for that, right? I mean, you should, but a lot of us don't, okay? How many of us really sage? How many of us really pray? How many of us actually really take the time to evaluate what's going on in our lives and actually care about what we let into our bodies? It's not even just about food, it's not about environment, it's not about air quality. A lot of it has to do with the people we let into our lives. And when it comes to people, I'm talking about sex. When you're letting people inside of you, you're literally inheriting their demons, and their demons are taking a part of you with them. I'm going to link down some sources down below so you guys can look into it, but it's a very real thing. That's why a lot of these hoes and shit that y'all know, for real, that's why they so miserable. That's why they're constantly always fucking and sucking any and everyone. That's why they're always like so hungry for sex, because it's like they're losing pieces of themselves every single time they fuck someone. That's why they're constantly soul searching, because their soul is tied to multiple different people. It's basically like they're giving pieces of their souls away, and they're never going to be whole until they find themselves again and honestly reclaim those parts of themselves. So realistically, I'm very sure that you guys don't want to deal with that, but if that's what you want to do, that's your business. Believe it or not, it's a real thing, and I really, really, really wish you guys would look into that more, because it's a lot more serious than you think it is. Of course, the whole thought culture, whole culture situation lowers your value, okay? We all know the neighborhood thought. Okay, we all know the neighborhood hoe. We talk about him or her in the most horrible ways. Even though all of us have fallen into the whole, I know I have it, unless I didn't know, but I know a lot of people fall into the whole situation of, oh, well, I'm gonna go mess with the hoe or the thought anyway. Maybe they're, you know, not as bad as everyone's saying that they are. You know, he's actually sweet in person. She's actually not that bad. Let me get to know her. Oh, she's actually not a hoe, blah, blah, blah. Maybe that's true, maybe it's not. Nonetheless, we can all agree that being a hoe or being a thot really ruins your reputation and really lowers your stock and lowers your value wherever it is, whether it be school, your neighborhood, your church, whatever. If you're known as a hoe, it kind of lowers your value and lowers your pool of people to date. Like, cause nobody wants to fucking date the hoe. It's like, even if it's just among the kids or among the younger people that, oh, blah, blah, blah's a hoe. Let's be real, your parents probably know that thot, thot, thot's kid is a thot. Now, say if you fuck around, you date that person, and now you try to bring them home, and now your parents looking at you like, why the fuck you bring this hoe in my house? Like, it just becomes a problem. You do not want to be that person that everybody knows was sucking dick in the back of the church. Let me stop talking shit, because you know what? Might get some DMs over this one. This is just ridiculous at this point, because a lot of people who push this whole culture are not like, okay, they're not like you and me. A lot of these people in the media, in the music, in the world are pushing this shit, and they're rich. Okay, they're privileged. If something happens to them, if they become baby mothers, if they get STDs, if they get talked about or whatever, they can go to therapy. They can take care of their kid. They can get treatment for their STDs. Bitch, you poor. Bitch, you in the hood. Bitch, you ain't pay your phone bill last month. What you gonna do? Please explain to me. Y'all wanna be like everybody that y'all watching, but understand y'all not like them. Bitch, you poor. If something happens to you, if you're sitting here throwing it in a circle, you sitting here sticking your dick in any and everything, if something happens to you, what are you going to do? Live on government assistance? You're gonna have an Uncle Sam baby. You're going to be having Uncle Sam insurance to pay for those STDs. You're going to end up living a life of misery. All of these people you follow are leading you to a dead ditch or leading you to a dead end road. Y'all need to stop following these people and listening to these people like they're fucking Bible, like they're fucking gospel. I already talked about this before in one of my videos, talking about like these female rappers and what they push. Okay, they all push struggle love. Okay, they talk about, you know, marrying these men, you know, talk about I don't cook, I don't clean, but I still got this ring. Like Cardi B, your nigga cheats on you every week and you're always in the vlogs because of him. Like, bitch, is this really what you want to follow? Nicki Minaj is really married to a whole sexual offender. Let's be real here. These people could be your faves. Y'all could be upset about what I said, but the fact is the fact. The proof is in the pudding. I'm going to link some resources down below, especially with the whole Nicki Minaj's husband situation. Like, the victim has been speaking out this past year about her being harassed by both Nicki and her husband. And y'all wanna sit there and ignore this shit because, oh, this is your fave. Oh, well, she's lying. Well, I can't wait. And I'm gonna say this right now. I said what I said. I can't wait for something like that to happen to you or one of your loved ones, and for y'all to sit there and try to say, oh, well, it's because it's my fave. Well, it didn't happen. Oh, well, it's a lie. If someone does that to you, I hope you still have that fucking energy, because y'all not shit. Do not discredit someone's story or not believe them just because the person accused is your fave. Just because you love the music of the person accused. We're not pushing modesty and wearing turtlenecks and wearing fucking dresses down to your toes to impress men. I ain't got time for that. And trust me, no one is here to impress men. Like, honestly, I personally believe that there's a lot of people who have the goal of just being by themselves, living by themselves, and prospering by themselves. And if that's for you, toodaloo, whatever, but still be mindful of soul ties in general, because that's just not good for you. But like, as a whole, if your goal is to be married, if your goal is to have children, all of this is super duper important. I'm not pushing the idea of not having fun. I'm pushing the idea of dating with purpose, having fun with purpose, actually doing shit with purpose, not just throwing it in a circle for fucking entertainment, not just posting your coochie and your titty pics online for fucking attention for 10 seconds. Like, a lot of y'all really have a lot of daddy and mommy issues, and it shows. Y'all need to go to a fucking family therapist, because this is ridiculous at this point. Y'all are fucking embarrassing. Y'all can have fun and all, but be about your business. I can't tell you how many people I know were on the track to being nurses, on the track to being doctors, on the track to being lawyers, engineers, rappers, basketball players, but they wanted to hoe around. They wanted to stick their dick into everything. They wanted to sit on everybody's face, and now all of a sudden they pregnant. Now they got STDs. Now all of a sudden they let their soul ties get the best of them, and now they bums. They strung out on drugs. They sitting on public assistance. They ain't doing nothing, no hope, no nothing, because they let some nothing ass bitch or some nothing ass nigga ruin their life. Do you want to be like that? Do you want to be like that all because you wanted to have 5 seconds of fun? All because you want to have an orgasm or 10? Do you really? Like, let's be real. Relationships are fun. Relationships are great with the right people. And sadly, a lot of us don't know how to pick the right people to date. I fucked up many times and picked the wrong niggas. However, I can say none of them ruined my life to the point where I was never about my shit. A lot of y'all have this problem where y'all get in a relationship and y'all completely fall out of what y'all were doing. All of a sudden, you wanna quit school. All of a sudden, you wanna quit church. All of a sudden, you wanna quit whatever it was that you were on the path to doing. You can't do that. If you know that you're the type of person that can't stay focused, you should not be in a relationship. Know that you need to focus on yourself and not focus on no man, no woman, no nothing, and then get into a relationship with someone that you know will benefit you, that you know will help you grow, not distract you, not deter you, not have you having sex every 2 seconds, not have you having sex outside of your relationship because you know that person's a cheater. That's another thing. Like, why willingly date someone that you know is promiscuous? It doesn't make sense. You willingly go and date the neighborhood thot and then be confused as to why they won't change. Understand, you're not Captain Save a Hoe. You will not save a hoe. A hoe gonna have to change on their own. And we're not talking about people that have hoe phases. We're not talking about that. We're talking about legitimate hoes. We all have that little phase that we all call a hoe phase, but it's not even a hoe phase. Okay, a hoe is a hoe. And sadly, most hoes actually have a sex addiction. Okay, a lot of them have a legitimate sex addiction that they've never gotten diagnosed, that they should go get diagnosed, because they really probably have a legitimate issue. I literally have had friends with sex addictions. It's a very serious thing. I'm not trying to poke fun. We're not having a joke session. We're not just talking shit here. This is a real serious thing. We're talking about people with legitimate addictions and people that legitimately can't keep their shit in their pants. Lots of things cause these problems, okay? Like I've said before on this channel, lack of a father figure, lack of a mother figure, sexual assault, or early exposure to sex itself. Of course, just regular defiance or rebellion, especially for those who grew up in a strict household, or just blatant miseducation or sheltering. Like, we all know those kids that have been sheltered so much that as soon as they get some freedom in like college, all of a sudden it's like church girl gone wild. Like, honestly, we need to have the conversation of sex with our kids early. We need to actually be there for our kids as parents, whether we live in the home with them or not. We need to actually watch our kids and make sure they're not being exposed to sex early. We need to make sure we don't bring them to any and everyone's house. We need to make sure that they're not being touched inappropriately. Like, these are very, very important things, because if not, your kid is most likely gonna be on the road to nowhere fast. Okay, I tell y'all, it all starts at home, because it always does. And I know people get so upset. Well, some of the parents get so upset when I say this, but it's true. Like, a lot of y'all be spending 12, 14, 15 hours at work and only 5 hours with your kids. I understand you need to put a roof over your kid's head, but the roof over the kid's head is not important if the kid's head over them, okay, their head is not straight. So with that being said, comment down below. What do you think about thought culture? Do you think that it is detrimental? Do you think it's not a problem? What do you think? I'd love to hear your thoughts and opinions down below. With that being said, make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that. I'ma see y'all next time.